third topic is Digital India. It has been introduced by our Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi. It included IT, CS, broadband and connectivity to modernize the country. The main aim was to provide connectivity to all the citizens of the country. It also have provided us with digital vaults such as DigiLocker, which could safeguard the information of the people. Each person has been provided with an authentication key so that he or she will gain access to it. Application can also be filled online, and many fake documents have been reduced because of digitalization. Digital India have introduced us with equipments like many other things like robots, which includes the knowledge of artificial intelligence, machine learning and data science. Our India have a cloud of computers and broadband with a vast network of optical fibers. Government has taken a good initiative to launch this scheme. But as we know that there are many hackers. Yeah, but many people don't know the difference between hackers and crackers. Hackers are the ethical people who hack for the government. But the crackers are unethical hackers which usually tend to harm people. Digital India have provided us connectivity with different parts of the world, but it have disadvantages. For instance, many get the message of fake message of like they have won the prize money, but many people are trapped in it. For instance, if you are working on a website which have a secure connection, but people work on a website for a long time and they do not recognize that they are working on a unsecure or secure website. So they provide their information to the server, and the server provides the information to the hackers. So now they get vulnerable, as we have also seen an example of a town known as Jamtara. It has been known for its hacking for a long time, and they are just collecting a huge amount of ransom from many people by just calling on the random call. So government should also take the initiative to stop this by hiring ethical hackers, ethical hackers, so that people will be safe. And people should also get aware of this, that they should not provide any information on the unsecure site, and also do not provide their credit card or account number on a random call. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Today's my lecture topic is Digital India. Digital India was launched by Government of India on 1st of July in the year 2015. The main aim of launching Digital India is to empower the people related to electronic means, online infrastructures and digital transactions, which they can do very easily, because in current scenarios the technologies are proliferating at very rapid rate. So the people living in the semi-urban and village area or in the remote areas, they have a problem with online transactions, whether it is booking tickets on train, or whether doing payment through Paytm or e-phone or e-wallets. So some of the codes which are the main propaganda of Digital India to deliver the government services to literate the people for the digital transactions, and thirdly, to make a safe platform for the people for both urban as well as the rural areas. Apart from this, there are various other digital programs which has been launched by the government to strengthen the Digital India. So like Bharat Mala project, Sagar Mala projects, industrial corridors, freight corridors, Make in India and Udan RCS. So the main point come out from Digital India is to improve the internet connectivity all over India, so that the people can do the transactions and learn through various portals without any inconvenience. So moving to the next point, some of the pros of Digital India is that there during this pandemic, everyone is relying on digital platform, whether for the job or for to learn something new. So it come as a boon or as a blessing for the people, because in this pandemic, it is not possible to go outside because of this deadly virus. And secondly, there are lot of study materials are available on digital platform through which anyone can get access to those. It doesn't matter whether that person is rich or poor. And thirdly, digital locker, it's very popular. If you want to save your documents of schools, colleges, or any other documents which are very confidential, so you can save it and you just have to provide one OTP password, which you don't have to share with other people. And the next one is eKranti. So eKranti is one of the best mobile platform through which all the government's schemes and services will be there, and you can even complain if you face any grievance. So some of the other positive of Digital India are it created 1.7 crore job directly, and if we talk in indirect manner, so around 8 crore job. So due to this, people are getting job. And secondly, people are getting much educated related to digital transactions, and it become very easier, because earlier we have to go in a bank in order to do transaction, in order to withdraw money. But due to Digital India, you can do the payment through online platforms through PhonePe, BharatPe. So some of the cons which are related to Digital India is that some of the critics say that instead of focusing on Digital India, government should focus on the basic necessities like water, power supply, and many other issues. And secondly, this scheme will only get successful if there will be a safeguard, because the cyber crime and the cyber security is one of the major hindrance against this, because there are higher probability that the money will be steal by the hackers, because they are very experienced. And so the next negative point is that in some of the cases, the government does not tell what will be the consequences of the repercussion if something bad happens. So they have to come up with better policies and the laws which can overcome all these challenges. So in conclusion, I would like to say that it is a great step taken by the government of India to digitalize everything, and it will also reduce terrorism and the corruptions, which is the main hindrance for the development of the nation. Thank you, everyone. Jai Hind.